Alright, continuing. Number four video. Try to move this along, but, you know, it's hard to just let it go. Just because there's so much of this is, you know, this guy wants to be president of the United States. He doesn't have a plan, any kind of real vision thing. He doesn't, nothing he can articulate, explain how he's going to make these changes in people. And that's what it requires. And, is he saying anything at all inspiring or anything that should mean anything to people who aren't living in his delusional perception of where they're living? I mean, he'll cite a statistic about black kids or something. Does he really understand what it is to grow up black or to grow up poor? Does he have any clue at all to what that, even growing up as a minority in a country? I mean, these are all things you have to actually spend time thinking about to have any capacity to really appreciate. You really can't know it if you don't spend any time thinking about it. And I mean by time more than split seconds of time. You have to actually take like minutes. You have to click off a clock while you think about all the things that would be different in your life if you didn't have a father, or if your father was beating your mother. All the ways that might fuck you up. And then you might be able to have a conversation with somebody in that situation that might be one they can appreciate. Because maybe you can just explain, look, I know you got it bad, but there's no point in making a bad situation worse. You know. And maybe I can ask people to give up something more too. Maybe I can ask the people who think it's a good idea to exploit the poor with a government-sponsored lottery gambling. Maybe I can actually say that's wrong, which Trump doesn't have the guts to say, even though he knows it's wrong, even though he knows it's exploitation, even though he knows this is a corruption of human character. He can't find the words to say that to people, that maybe you shouldn't drink as much, that maybe if you're going to start ridiculing what poor people do, maybe you and your comfortable life ought to be able to moderate some of your vice, some of your bad behavior, as an example. That, look, I can give up something too. I know what it is to sacrifice something for civilization. I know I'm squandering my productivity. So if you're going to tell a kid in the hood that they're squandering their capacity to contribute, then maybe you should point out how, or acknowledge that you're doing the same thing and that you could do better. Something like that. Something a little bit more real than this tripe that people feed on. Fuck.
Chicago, in Detroit, in Ferguson, who have really, in every way, folks, the same right to live out their dreams as any other child.
Yeah, this right thing doesn't mean anything, because we know it's about privilege, jackass. You didn't have, it wasn't because you had a right to it that you got it. You got it because you had a rich daddy. Everything you own now, every place you've been, everything you've had is completely dependent on that circumstance. And you're telling me that you think, you know, somehow it all would have turned out the same story if your father died when you were 16 and left $30,000 of debt on the mortgage. Fuck you.
In America, any other child.
So that's the inspiring message. You all have rights, and the rights will take care of it. The magical right to inherit money will take care of your poverty. It'll fix it, because you'll have the right to have a rich daddy. Fuck.
To make life safe for all of our citizens, we must also address the growing...
Yeah, you must have a delusion is what you must have. That's all. There's no other thing you can have to have such an idiotic notion that you're going to somehow spread it without giving anything. Ah, we give nothing and we spread this wonder. Wonder and beauty spread everywhere. We don't feed it. We don't create it. We're not going to pay for it. But yeah, it'll be spread. Yeah, bullshit's being spread.
Threats we face from outside the country. We are going to defeat the barbarians of ISIS, and we're going to defeat them fast.
All right, so I, you know, these people say this guy's anti-war. That sounds like war to me. I just don't really understand how exactly you're going to defeat them without killing them. They're really motivated, highly passionate people. They believe this ignorant slop of a religion. Now, you won't get to the core philosophy of human beings. Nobody, you still think it's politically incorrect to say religious people are retarded. You'll lie about the Christian Bible and claim it's your favorite book. I mean, it's a disgusting and overt lie, and you goddamn know it. And you talk about political correctness and how there's too much political correctness. Don't tell me you're not being politically correct when you don't have the balls to say it's a silly goddamn fucking nursery rhyme book. All right, it has a couple of good messages in it, and the rest of it's crap. I mean, really, he doesn't, obviously he doesn't believe any of it. It says in the Bible 7 fucking times, your odds of getting into the kingdom of God if you're a rich man are those of a camel going through the eye of a needle. Fuck. So, I mean, this is, the, you know, they're still plotting. War, we're going to murder the philosophically ignorant. We will not negotiate. We will not talk. We will not try to find resolution. We will annihilate them with our war machine. Isn't that what he just said? He didn't say, we're going to defeat them. We're going to, he didn't do a, you know, a, what was it, Khrushchev? What was the guy's name? No, that's a, his, well, anyway. We'll bury you on the ash heap of history. You know, he didn't do a metaphor like, yeah, we'll prove you to be wrong and we'll demonstrate your philosophy to be bankrupt. You know, no. Sounds like a kill speech. We will kill you.
Once again, France is the victim of brutal Islamic terrorism. Men, women, and children viciously mowed down. Lives ruined.
Right, in a guerrilla war being financed by oil money.
Families ripped apart. A nation in mourning. The damage and devastation that can be inflicted by Islamic radicals has been proven over and over.
Yeah, and the damage and horror and, you know, of our daisy cutters has been proven over and over. Our shock and awe beautiful fireworks are extremely expensive in terms of the lives they tragically end. So what does this bullshit mean? You don't really think it's a war, and you think the people that don't have weapons should just concede they lost. They should just give up because they don't have weapons. So, you know, I mean, it was perfectly appropriate for the Spaniards to show up and just tell the Incas and the Aztecs and everybody else, just give up because we have weapons, we have horses, you don't, you lose.
At the World Trade Center, at an office party in San Bernardino, at the Boston Marathon, at a military recruit.
Right. Again, and what kind of fanatic is this? It's not even the regular fanatic. These are crazy people. So again, bring up the government building that Timothy McVeigh blew up. Bring up the psychotic religious kook who was molesting his own kids and the FBI spent 6 months wasting their time negotiating with and then got sued because they finally said, fuck this. And they were wrong. Why don't you bring that up, shithead?
Big Center in Chattanooga, Tennessee, and many, many other locations. Only weeks ago, in
Oklahoma City. Entire building blown up by a Christian fanatic.
Orlando, Florida.
I mean, he wasn't really much of a Christian, let's be clear. Again, he's just a fanatic against anything hostile to the right of religious kooks to be armed and dangerous.
49 wonderful Americans were savagely murdered by an Islamic terrorist.
Again, by a crazy person. So again, you want to, you know, they're not soldiers in the war. They're not government sponsored. They're not in any way part of the Islamic CIA. They're not operatives as we have in other people's countries trying to foment revolution. They're not any of the shit like that. And you're going to say you have a cure for insanity. Oh, okay. What?
This time...
Just be more insane so the insane people don't look insane? Is that your plan? I will make America look so fucking crazy and butt shit out of its brain that it will make all the crazy people look rational. That's the plan, correct? I mean, the audience here and this rhetoric certainly indicates that must be your plan.
The terrorist target. LGBTQ community. No good. And we're going to stop it.
We're going to stop it. He's going to stop at the LGBTQHAA community. The Down syndrome, Asperger'd, gay, fucked in the head, pointy haired, too much body hair community. I mean, let's all have a... Are you part of the small penis community? I mean, do you have a frickin' card that you carry with you around just so everybody knows? I have a very small penis, so don't pull my pants down because I have a very small penis. Do you have that card in your wallet, fuckhead? Too much politically correct! And then he does a politically correct, I will blow your dicks, homo guys, okay? So, just... Play along with me. I'll say a couple of things that are offensive, but I'll blow you later. For sure. Oh, there's a cheesehead in the fucking goddamn audience. Crazy, yes? Shoot the gate. I mean... Don't shoot gays. What's the solution? Give more crazy people guns. Give more crazy people guns.
As your president.
Gay lives matter. What are they saying?
President, I will do everything in my power to protect our LGBTQ citizens.
I mean, what the hell is this? Like, sounds like a sandwich. LGBTQ. What's the Q? Queer? What is that? Q? There's a Q citizen somewhere? Quiet? What the hell is Q? Fuck. I'm just totally... Yeah, I'm just no longer in the stream, right? Because I don't know how the fuck you could put a Q in front of anything that's called an organization.
From the violence and oppression of a hateful foreign ideology.
And how will you do that? Exactly how will you do that? Burn down the mosques? Give all the Muslims in America a spanking?
Believe me.
Believe what? Most of all these people were American citizens. What, you're going to deport them or something? What are you going to do? Say, you can't be a Muslim. I'm all for it. I mean, I love a law that says if you're a Muslim, you have to leave. It's okay with me, but say it about Catholics, too. I got no use for those cunts, either. They put Jack Kevorkian in jail for 7 years, the motherfuckers. Yeah, we ought to tear down St. Patrick's Cathedral. Put up a fucking Stuckey's or something. Fuck the Catholics. Fuck the Muslims. Fuck all the ignorant cunts with their silly, idiotic philosophies who wish to tell other people they don't have reality right because they believe in physics and evolution. Fuck them! your fucking demon worshippers, your friend Sarah Palin, who thinks there's demons possessing people. What, are you going to do a demon chant? Is that what you're going to do, Donald? You're going to exorcise the demons out of the Muslims? Like in some kind of biblical way? You're going to do some hokey pokey word sauce you're going to throw on top of them? You know, some sort of voodoo, wear a funky hat, and, you know, dispossess them of the demons? Stop them gays! Kill them gays! What the hell are they saying? I like applesauce on my pork chops.
And I have to say, as a Republican...
yeah, so let's point that out. As an idiot...
It is so nice to hear you cheering for what I just said. Thank you.
Oh, yes, as a Republican, I love that you people aren't saying, let's stone the gays. Oh, you were saying that? Oh, my bad. Sorry, yeah, go continue. So, yeah, I thought you were saying something nice. I didn't know you were saying stone the gays. Jeez. Thank you for not believing in demons like Sarah Palin. Thank you. Trump is America's great ball of fire. Wow, these are Einsteins. That's just poetry. It's going to have the earth on fire. It's going to be a great ball of fucking... We're already, right? It'll just keep being the warmest year in history. The warmest year in history. Trump will just keep saying, those are just statistical anomalies.
To protect us from terrorism, we need to focus on three things.
Ah, here we go. Now the focusing part. Let's do some focusing. So it's time for the lens of knowledge. Here we go.
We must have the best, absolutely the best gathering of intelligence anywhere in the world.
Well, yeah, well, I don't know. So what? More CIA bullshit. More game playing. Oh, great. Let's have more subversive, what do you call those? What the old days, we had a word for those. Narcs. Yeah. Let's have more narcs among the people. Yeah. Especially the foreign people. You know, let's put traitors in their groups and stuff, so we can maliciously fuck them. You know, you deserve what you get, okay? Play the game and get burned by the game. You know, the Muslims are playing the same game, right? They come over and say, no, me, I want to be American. Yeah, I love America. Oh, I love America. I learned how to sing America. Instead of war, and jihad, no, I'm no jihadi, no, love America, la, 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 la. Yeah, and then they blow you up, you fuck. So yeah, you want to make some of those guys and send them over into their territory to fuck with them. Brilliant. The CIA has done wonders for us, right? The whole Shah of Iran, the whole fucking thing was created by these stupid assholes playing these stupid covert fucking games.
The best.
And who would that be? Eric or Little Donald? Little Eric or Little Donald? Who's... Oh, maybe it's Ivanka. Ivanka would be... Yeah, she's totally spy-worthy. Yeah. I think she already is one.
We must abandon the failed policy of nation-building and regime change that Hillary Clinton pushed in Iraq, in Libya, in Egypt, and in Syria.
And what is your plan? Let's leave them exactly the way they are and spy on them, and then blow them up. No, same thing.
Instead, we must work with all of our allies who share our goal of destroying ISIS and...
We haven't been down that road before. Let's pay a bunch of allies and bribe a bunch of allies and extort a bunch of allies to agree with our policy. Yeah, we haven't done that before. That worked out so well in Iran.
Stamping out Islamic terrorism and doing it now, doing it quickly. We're going to win. We're going to win fast.
I mean, really, this rhetoric, you people really think that they don't make the same speeches in Iraq or Iran and say, look, the evil empire hates our religion. They hate our identity. They hate our character. They hate our culture. And they're overtly attempting to destroy us. Listen to them. They're overtly trying to do it. They want to send operatives over here to spy on us and do all kinds of chicanery. Up the ante on the war rhetoric. Just too brilliant.
Such.
I don't need that to be making noises. I think I will turn the audio notices off. Thank you very much. So again, no articulated plan here. We need to do three things. We need to focus. And the focus is somehow we're just going to have a silent war and we're going to win. Okay. Okay, so now they're chanting USA. He just said, let's get an agreement with the rest of the world, and as a united force, let's fight this evil as an entire... let's all agree that Islamic fanaticism is dangerous and out of control, and that we have to put these people in a cage of some kind to prevent them from destroying our way of life and our civilization. So we, as the nations of the world, need to agree that there's a limit. We won't allow you to be this crazy. We'll allow you to be this crazy, but you can't be this crazy. And they're chanting USA, USA, USA. They're just not even on the same page, right? They're not even listening to the speech. Fucktards.
This includes working with our greatest ally in the region, the State of Israel.
Our greatest ally in the region and the most messy sticking point of the entire conflict, and we have to work with them. We finance them. We don't get to sit there and say, hey, look, you're going to have to put some reins on your abuse of the slaves, which they are, the people in the concentration camp you're running. And it's essentially a concentration camp Israel is running. That's what Palestine is now. They are controlling the electricity. They are controlling the water. They are controlling the resources. Just understand, Judaism is just another crackpot, stupid fucking cunt religion. And if the Jews want to say they're a race, well, then they're just racist cunts saying we need a special racially pure country. So none of this goes anywhere. This whole Israel thing is just kind of crap. Build a wall around Israel, not a wall around America. Yeah, that would be a good idea. Just build a really big wall so the Israelis can't even see the Palestinians anymore.
I have said that NATO was obsolete.
Maybe a dome. Just put a big dome over Israel.
Because it did not properly cover terror. And also that many of the member countries were not paying their fair share.
whatever that is, their fair share into what? Our insane plan to piss away trillions of dollars driving people into the Stone Age. Yeah, I wouldn't be financing that plan either.
As usual, the United States has been picking up the cost. Shortly thereafter, it was announced that NATO will be setting up a new program in order to combat terrorism. A true step in the right direction.
Yeah, whatever that even means, right? The NATO plan will be to what? Find a rock to hide under?
Lastly, and very importantly, we must immediately suspend...
That was more than three things, I'm sure.
...suspend immigration from any nation that has been compromised by terrorism until such time as proven vetting mechanisms have been put in place. We don't want them in our country.
All right, and right, and they should say the same things to our oil companies and all the rest of it, because they're all CIA agents, right? So, yes, we should go ahead and implement such a plan of segregation and separation and see what that'll get you. Let's just put up a big sign that says white only. Yeah. Just, why not?
My opponent has called for a radical 550% increase in Syrian. Think of this. Think of this. This is not believable, but this is what's happening. A 550% increase in Syrian refugees on top of the existing massive refugee flows coming into our country already under the...
Yeah, well, whatever. This was basically our CIA that created this fake Islamic Spring or whatever the fuck it was. We're the ones that created the problem. I'm not for taking them in. I'm for doing that tent thing, the United Nations tent thing. Yeah, just give the UN some money to put some tents near Syria. And if you have to make a new Syria, go ahead, make a new Syria somewhere. Tent city Syria, and then let it slowly grow into a new little Palestine or something. Right. But yeah, it's our mess. There's nobody else who made this mess but us. We made the mess, Donald. You're going to pretend we didn't do it? So obviously the stupid cunt who was part of the mess making is saying we have to clean it up, and that's, you know, she's a stupid cunt. I agree.
The leadership of President Obama. She proposes...
Yes, I mean, the stupid military-industrial complex Democrats, this really is a problem. I mean, they've been nagged for years by you assholes talking about, oh, they're weak on defense, and they're weak on defense, and they don't make enough wars, and so they finally make more wars, and then you sit there and rag on them. Irony much?
This, despite the fact that there's no way to screen these refugees in order to find out who they are, or where they come from.
Right, just like nobody can trust us, you know, CIA agent, no way to vet to figure out if he's a CIA agent, so yeah, you're fucked. Social Security numbers, maybe we need that. International Social Security number. Yeah, your whole history would be online somewhere, in a database somewhere.
I only want to admit individuals into our country who will support our values and love our people.
Well, if I, you ought to kick me out then, because I can't love these assholes, not even close. So, yeah, you ought to just have that as a rule, you know, just say, yeah, let's have a civil war and decide to, if you love Americans, then you're on one side, and if you think Americans are ignorant cunts, you're on the other side. Yeah. I mean, immigration just isn't, there's nothing you can make productive out of it anymore. It just isn't. I mean, you know, there's just, we have in place, you know, the civilization is almost too good for immigration. I think the European Union's run into the same problem. See, I mean, back in the old days, when the Irish and the Italians came over here and all that kind of stuff, or the Chinamen, there was no welfare state. There was no help at all. They had to suffer all kinds of indignities and horrors. No health care, you know, no infrastructure at all. They had to make it all themselves in their poverty. And it was horrible. I'm not saying it was a good thing. I'm saying that was horrible. But you can't afford to do it any other way, realistically. That immigration would have been too expensive if we had social infrastructure and attempted to take care of all the, made all the babies to live and gave everybody everything. It would have been totally unproductive. Just a fact. So immigration under these terms, where the huddled masses are nothing but a huge liability, a very expensive liability, is just fucking dumb. Especially when they're driving wages down. Because we already have too much labor.
Anyone who endorses violence, hatred, or oppression is not...
Yeah, whatever that is. So what are you endorsing exactly against ISIS? Violence? Oh.
Not welcome in our country and never ever will be.
Because we say when we get to shoot. We have the guns. We have more guns than anybody. But we don't want any gun nuts coming here.
Decades of record immigration have produced lower wages and...
Right, started by Ronald the Reagan, okay? Ronald the Reagan, the guy who was talking the same crap as you are, okay, about the damn foreigners, doubled legal immigration, and then they doubled it again. Then they just keep increasing it, and they just keep coming up with chicanery to make excuses for it. So, yes, it's quite obvious that the system, as produced by both the Democrats and the Republicans, is pro-immigration. And your rhetoric doesn't mean anything, because you're just saying these words. You don't have any hope or clue or policy to have any of this implemented.
Higher unemployment for our citizens, especially for African American and Latino workers. We are going to...
Again, why especially four? I mean, that just doesn't even mean anything either in this context. Poverty is the problem. A lack of a sufficient wage for any, whether you're white or black, it's not enough money to live on. Doesn't, you know, both races need calories to live. You know, the same roof is required.
Have an immigration system that works, but one that works for the American people.
And that only happens when it's gross exploitation. Again, there's no example of immigration that was ever worked for the American people that didn't suck the blood out of the victims of the immigration. So, especially the first couple of generations. So, you know, you can't have it both ways. You can't pretend you're civilized and take advantage, and then pretend, well, we had to because that's what they wanted to do. They wanted to love America, and, you know, part of loving America is, yeah, we get to grind you into the American dirt.
On Monday, we heard from three parents whose children were killed by illegal immigrants. Marianne Mendoza, Sabine
Dirt, and my friend, Jamil Shaw.
Right, and none of the people who were killed by the American citizens, or did you meet with them? There was people killed by American citizens. Did you meet with them?
They're just three brave representatives of many thousands who have suffered so gravely. Of all my travels in this country, nothing has affected me more. Nothing even close, I have to tell you.
Okay, then what? So we have Ground Zero. That should affect the fuck out of you. And then you have the Oklahoma City. You could go there and be pretty fucking affected.
Then the time I have spent with the mothers and fathers who have lost their children to violence spilling across our borders, which we can solve.
Right. So again, the victims of Oklahoma City, the people whose children were blown up, those victims are, whatever. And the important victims are the ones that are for this political purpose. That's honest coppery again.
We have to solve it!
Yes, all of the indecencies committed by human beings need to be solved, so I would argue that everybody needs an ankle bracelet, and we need to track what everybody's up to, and because everybody's cheating and conniving and sleeping with somebody else's wife and doing all kinds of things, and frankly, we should catch them all. Give them all a spanking.
These families have no special interests to represent. There are no demonstrators to protect them, and certainly none to protest on their behalf. My opponent will never meet.
What are you talking about? Yeah, what the hell was that? Just a litany of complete bullshit. It seems there's a ton of people demonstrating all over the place in your fucking audience right there, holding up signs and shit. Fuck. Racist for Trump. Yeah, it's kind of obvious, right? Yeah, you know, KKK for Trump. Yeah, you know, it's kind of obvious, right?
Meet with them or share in their pain, believe me. Instead, my opponent wants sanctuary cities. But where was the sanctuary?
I'll concede the point, okay? Hillary Clinton is an idiot on some subjects, but she's not as big an idiot as you on most subjects, and she would never be crack shit insane enough to say something. This guy's supposed to know something about economics, and he talks about defaulting on the debt. And, you know, people really don't get it, but the debt is basically owned by American rich people, most of it. And it's owned by the banks in the sense that the banks are using it to, hedge and to, there's another word for it. It's basically all mortgaged. So it's basically reconverted into stock market gains. And so if you defaulted on the debt, you're basically taking $40 trillion out of the stock market. So that's what people are cheering. Yay! $40 trillion out of the stock market. Yay! It's going to happen anyway, but I'm just saying, doing it on purpose sounds kind of retarded. Really retarded.
Sanctuary for Kate Steinle. Where was the sanctuary for the children of Marianne and Sabine and Jamil? Where was the sanctuary?
Right, you could just go about, where was the sanctuary? I could just give you the list of all the people, the poor people, and often black, that were killed by cops this year. Okay, yeah, let's do that. Who didn't have guns. Who were minding essentially their own business until some cop decided to fuck the game.
For all of the other... it's so sad to even be talking about it, because we can solve this problem so quickly. Where was the sanctuary?
Right, quickly by building a wall, a gigantic, huge expense. So instead of building another Hoover Dam, let's waste the money on I can't even think of anything more wasteful. On a pile of rocks. Let's build the biggest pile of rocks that do absolutely nothing. Let's build a statue of Trump. It'd be just as stupid. A gigantic, huge, as big as the Hoover Dam statue of Donald Trump. Yeah, just as useless. So instead of investing in America, because you love Americans, you'll just piss away your resources that you've exploited out of the poor people in the first place. It's all really quite disgusting. The appropriate gesture still. Yeah, I mean, he must have his crazy glue. He must have his fingers glued together. I mean, he's been doing that forever. I mean, since like 1956 or something. This is Trump. It doesn't look like the Trump symbol, right? I mean, this doesn't zero. That part makes sense. Little finger puppet. That makes sense. It's got the brain of a finger puppet.
For all of the other Americans who have been so brutally murdered and who have suffered so horribly. These wounded American families have been alone. But they are not alone any longer.
Right, and there's statistically, many thousand times more wounded families from drunk driving. Yes, you're going to make a speech about that. Lots more victims, you know, just the truth. Completely unnecessary victims of silly, sloppy recklessness. But that's not a crime. those aren't real victims. That's not like, you know, when you die that way, it's nothing like having a plane crash on you. Nothing at all. Yeah, it is. Just like it. Retards for the retard. Yeah. Yes. Have that sign. Retards for the retard.
This candidate and the whole nation stand in their corner to support them, to send them our love, and to pledge in their honor that we will save countless more families from suffering and the same.
You probably can count them. I mean, statistically, there's a statistical amount, you know, that there's a certain number of people harmed by illegal aliens every year, and this is kind of a confined number, and you can sort of just project that into the future if you say, well, we'll not make any more of these, and slowly but surely the number of people killed by them will decrease as the number increases of the domestic crazy fucks.
In awful fate.
I mean, understand, this is just one of the liabilities of immigration, right? Forever, it always has been. The huddled masses have within them. The people who are huddled are usually huddled because they're a little bit dysfunctional, and the people in their own country didn't like them, and they weren't getting along, and that's why they're leaving somewhere, is because they're not playing by those rules. And so they show up to a new place and say, well, I can make my own rules here, and you know, some of that's true, because they usually did go to places that were expanding and had room for them to go out and be a mountain man or something. And true. And they could make little segregated communities. You know, they could get a little town and make it Chinatown. You heard of that, right? Chinatown? Well, Chinatown wasn't in China. It was, you know, in America. Yeah. True.
We are going to build a great border wall to stop illegal immigration. To stop the...
that'll stop the Islamic crap. Because, man, you got so many Islamis flying across that Mexican border, for fuck's sake. So, yeah, that'll save us all those Islamist terrorists. Well, we're sure going to be protected from them, because the Great Wall of Mexico will solve that problem. I mean, clearly, whatever you implement to stop the, you know, well, I'm just saying, employer sanction solves the problem. Real social security number solves the problem. You do it on one computer, game over, no more of this nonsense. Everybody's in the database, no big deal. The employer punches in your social security number, finds out that Hey, you're in New Jersey. You're supposed to be living in Omaha, asshole, and you're a foot shorter. How the hell did you work that out, jackass? Oh, and you're alive and you died 58 years ago. How'd you do that? Fuck you, get out of here. Not complicated.
Gangs and the violence and to stop the drugs from pouring into our communities.
Oh, a drug war. Yeah, we all need a bigger, expanded drug war because we know that's not completely corrosive to the community. So if you increase the price of heroin and marijuana and crack, that won't create any street violence or gang violence in the ghetto, will it? No, increased prices won't create any kind of warfare on the streets. Oh, wait a minute. I mean, this is something you could, like, this is another thing you could do on that little computer. Just get one computer and you could do this correlation of increase in drug prices, death by drug violence. The lines are exactly, they go exactly this, whatever one line goes, the other line follows it. Make drugs cheap, and then all of a sudden nobody shoots anybody over it. Yeah, wow, solution. You're stupid. Stupid white people.
I have been honored to receive the endorsement of America's Border Patrol agents.
Yeah. Gee, self-interest much? I mean, I'm going to spend $1 trillion building you, like, four-wheel drive vehicles to zoom back and forth across a paved wall highway. Oh yeah, I'm for that. I don't have to go out in the desert anymore. I can just zoom around on my four-wheeler on the wall. Oh, cool. And I got laser guns. Cool. Yeah, I'm for Trump. Duh. Yeah. Fuck.
And will work directly with them to protect the integrity of our lawful immigration system.
Lawful immigration system. Lawful immigration system. You know, the one where we let a bunch of migrants in every year for 6 months to pick all the fruit and do all that kind of stuff because, you know, we want the cheap labor. And then we tell them, que casa su casa es socio. Go homeo. Okay, come backio, springio, okayo? Yeah, that's class. That's showing your real integrity. You know, let them be illegal for 6 months at a time.
Lawful.
Good, solid American businessmen making good, solid American exploitation dollars. That's good. When we can exploit them cleanly and confine them to a localized space and they don't have any access to guns, yeah. Good. But cities? No. We don't want no immigrants in no cities. We just want them on the farm picking cotton. Fuck!
By ending catch and release on the border, we will end the cycle of human smuggling and violence.
Catch and release, and instead there should be what? Catch and... What? Like they cost less when they're in prison? Newsflash, welfare's cheaper than prison. Oh, fuck.
Legal border crossings will go down. We will stop it. It won't be happening very much anymore.
Oh, yeah, really. I'm just saying, okay, first off, okay, wall facts, okay? For a wall to work, you have to put soldiers on it and guard it, okay? Because walls are just made for desecration. And the East Germans learned that and all that kind of stuff. I mean, it's just a fact. There's no... Your wall is just something fun to shit on, okay, if you don't guard it. And we're already in Droneville, in the sense that when you were now using police robots to blow up criminals, you really think the Mexicans don't have enough pig shit in Mexico to make some explosives, for fuck's sake, and have some fun, you know, just for the fun of it. I really think there's Americans who would go on a fun jaunt into Mexico just to desecrate the wall. It would just be a fun weekend, go wall desecrating.
Believe me.
Or not. And I think I will choose the not. Thank you very much. Believe who? The guy who won't show us his tax return? The guy who says, well, even though I have a charitable foundation set up explicitly for the purpose of doing charity in a efficient and completely above-board manner, I do all my charity privately. Yeah. Because I don't want a tax write-off. It's Donald Trump. The guy who won't spend enough money to have somebody with a little bit of integrity write speeches for his fucking wife. Right? That guy doesn't want the tax deduction. Sure he doesn't.
Peace will be restored by enforcing the rules for millions who overstay their visas. Our laws will finally receive the respect that they...
Again, and who's going to pay for it? It's expensive to deport people. Costs money. Somebody has to pay for it. Blah, 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 blah. I mean, it's negotiating, right? He's supposed to be the great negotiator. You negotiate. You say, look, 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 your visa's expired, but you really got to, if you do this American thing, come on. Come on, you can do it. You know, you can try a little harder, right? So, yeah, we'll cut you a break, and you try a little harder to try to be a citizen and all that kind of shit. You know, what they ought to get rid of is this capacity to be in our country and call yourself a resident alien. That they should get rid of. You either become a citizen or you just get the fuck out. I mean, really. Resident alien? Fuck that.
They deserve. Tonight, I want every American whose demands for immigration security have been denied, and every politician who has denied them, to listen very, very closely to the words I am about to say.
Blah, 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 blah. Funny face, funny face. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, listen carefully. Blah, 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 blah.
Of 2017, the day I take the oath of office.
Und Feind und Kontrabund. Isn't that what he says? He's just such a fucking Hitler.
Und Giant Blut of Hunter Country Condo Abundant! Giant of Abundant!
It's German. It's slang German.
Americans will finally wake up in a country.
they'll finally wake up. Pause. In a country. Yeah, so, we're gonna wake up in a country run by a fucking psychotic, compulsive, lying, goddamn shit for turd brain, fuck witted Hitler wannabe. Oh, damn. Depressing.
Where the laws of the United States are enforced.
Unerring superiority, first priority. Fuck you, foreigner.
Yeah.
Until they have blonde hair, then they can come in.
Yay! Fatties for Trump! Yay! We're all kind of fat. Yes.
Oh, that's a look, fella. Yeah, that's a really cool look.
Well, I'm Asian black man. Yeah. I went to Japan. I'm an Asian black man now. Yeah.
Asian black man. Oh, yeah, see.
We are going to be considerate and compassionate to everyone.
Except the people we're going to blow up and the ones we're going to spy on. Yeah, fuck them.
But my greatest compassion will be for our own struggling citizens.
Yes, okay. It sort of makes sense. Citizenship should have some privileges. It shouldn't be like all burden and debt and shit. You know, I'd like to be a resident alien and just basically say, all of your problems are not my problem, okay, America? Fuck you. Okay, yes, you can have my vote. You can have all these fun little privileges that don't mean anything. I mean, the right to vote for an asshole or a lunatic isn't much of a fucking goddamn right, in my opinion. And I've never in my whole life had a fucking congressman. I mean, I keep voting for somebody, and somehow my vote doesn't mean anything because I don't get a representative ever. I get whatever my neighbor says my representative is. He tells me what I want to have as a representative. He represents me for me. So it's a fucked democracy. Why the fuck we have a system like that where we just decide to disenfranchise half the population every election when they should have representatives that get to have an argument and get to argue a cause? But instead, we turn everybody into a Democrat or a Republican and say, you have to be one of these two assholes or you're out of luck. I don't want to be one of you assholes. But I do want a representative. An honest man. The kind you put in jail. Like Jack Kevorkian. So anyway, that's a good place to end. So till the next time. You know, I had to waste the middle of my fucking day. Nice sunny day, and I'm wasting it on this shit. Fuck. Fucked hearted world we live in. I hate you. Yeah, I really don't like you at all. I always hated Donald Trump. For the first time I even saw him, and I just, oh God, he's so obnoxious. Ugh. I mean, boy, you just wish you could go back in time and beat the shit out of him when he was 13 years old. Little fucking arrogant cunt. Never won a fair fight in his fucking life. Had daddy do it for him. Still no mention of daddy anywhere in all of this. No mention of the daddy who made it all possible. Nothing else made it possible, really. I mean, frankly, right? There's nothing more critical to Donald Trump's success that could ever be stated to be critical to Donald Trump's success than daddy's money. And yet he hasn't mentioned daddy or the source of daddy's money. Kind of bullshit, ain't it? It's like when the Trump spawn later in life, never mentioning the Donald. Oh no, the Donald didn't have anything to do with me being Ivanka the star. No, I already had Ivanka power. I didn't need a Trumpy daddy. Yeah, no. And little Eric. I mean, Eric is just such a shining star of brilliance. You know, he's like a Sam Harris. He's just so full of intellectual powers.
My name's Eric. Yeah, Eric Trumpy. Yeah. I say Trumpy because it makes it happier. Yeah. My name's Eric. Did I say that? Yeah. My name's Eric. Yeah. I can make faces too, but I'm a little more dignified than daddy. Some people say I'm boring, but I'm not really boring. Or dim. My eyes are half open because, I have a little Down syndrome. Yeah, I got a little bit of Asperger's. And so my eyelids are a little floppy. So I look like I'm asleep, but I'm not really asleep. I just look like that. My name's Eric. Did I say that?
Yeah, like he wouldn't be fucking working at a fucking tampon factory if it wasn't for daddy. Shit. Shit. Anyway. Till next time, Sanj. Have a nice day. I love you, Americans. I just love you. With all my heart.